1 month ago, Blackpen Redpen uploaded 7 factorials you probably didn't know. Link in the description. In this video, he talks about 7 functions which are closely related to factorial. For example, double factorial, primorial, or Sloan's superfactorial. Although I love these special functions and I think Blackpen Redpen did a great job in showcasing them, I'm truly disappointed because he missed one of the most cool and interesting ones, the swinging factorial. In this video, I want to make up for his mistake and show you the beauty of swing. Let's start with the definition, which is actually very nice on its own because it involves my favorite function, floor function. Swing factorial of n is denoted as n with some kind of flipped and squished s, and it's given by the formula n factorial over floor of n over 2, factorial n squared. For example, swing factorial 5 is just equal to 5 factorial over 2 factorial squared, because floor of 5 over 2 is just equal to 2. Hence, swing factorial 5 is equal to 120 divided by 4, which is equal to 30. Per usual, all values of such factorial functions are integers, which might seem not very obvious in this case, but when we introduce an alternative definition, everything will become much clearer. In doing so, we'll need some help from our old friend binomial coefficient. If you don't know what a binomial coefficient is, check out this video. Let's denote b of n as n choose floor of n over 2 as the middle binomial coefficient. Middle because when we look at the Pascal's triangle, this b of n will always be the most centered term in a row. Then, swinging factorial of n can be defined as b of n for even n's and b of n times n plus 1 over 2 for odd n's. Since binomial coefficient is always an integer, swinging factorial of n also needs to be always an integer. Here's a sequence of swinging factorial of next natural numbers starting at n equals to 0. The thing about these numbers is that they are much smaller than factorials, and in fact, they're pretty easy to factor. There exists a theorem that gives an expression for the exponent of the largest power of a prime p that divides the swinging factorial of n, and it looks exactly like this. And I know it looks enormous and not very appealing, but believe me, it is important. This theorem is a base for an algorithm named swing, divide, and conquer, which calculates n factorial, and it actually is one of the fastest ones out there. More detail on this algorithm can be found in an article made by Peter Lashney, which you can find, among other cool things, on his website Fast Factorial Algorithms. Link in the description. Talking about cool websites, do you know what OEIS is? It stands for Online Encyclopedia of Integer Sequences, and it is the biggest of its kind. In short, it was created by Neil Sloan, who made plenty of videos with Numberphile actually on some of the most strange, iconic, or beautiful integer sequences. OEIS contains information about all integer sequences known to humans, and it's no different in the swinging factorial sequence case. Its dedicated site contains, among others, a list of 400 terms, few real-life applications, and a lot of links related to the swinging factorial. There is one specific thing out there that really caught my eye. It's a comment which says that the sum of reciprocals of the next swing factorials converges to a really nice constant named swinging e. This can be proved by converting the factorial function to a gamma function and then applying the beta function. If you want to see a full proof, the link is in the description. We are coming to an end of this video, but I want to talk about one more thing. The swinging factorions. But before we get to that, let me explain what a factorion is. Factorion is an integer that happens to be equal to the sum of factorials of its digits in base 10. For example, 145 is a factorion because it is equal to 1 factorial plus 4 factorial plus 5 factorial. Similarly, we can define swinging factorials as integers that happen to be equal to the sum of swinging factorials of its digits in base 10. I managed to find three of this, 1, 2 and 147. And it actually turns out that these are the only ones out there. And here's why. First of all, we need to notice that if we look at the swing factorials of digits, swing factorial of 9 is the largest one among this list. Now if we take a 5-digit number, ABCDE, the sum of swing factorial of its digits must be smaller than 5 times swing factor of 9. This number equals 3150, and it clearly is a 4-digit number, and hence it is smaller than any 5-digit number. Hence we proved that a 5-digit integer can be a swinging factorion, and since we can apply this method to any number which has more than 5 digits, we know that swing factorions must have 4 or less digits. What's interesting about this method is that it can be used to prove finiteness of any type of factorions, including the ones produced by functions mentioned by Black Pen Red Pen. And generally, any of his functions have equally interesting properties as the swinging one. So I hope this video encouraged you to do a little bit of digging on your own, and who knows, maybe you'll be the one to discover another amazing factorial function. See ya! Black Pen, Red Pen, I love you. I didn't mean to criticize you, okay? I only have a few seconds here until they... Oh no, they're coming. Gotta go.